So your child has myopia. What are we going to do about it? Myopia is the scientific word for nearsightedness. Nearsightedness means that when your child looks up close, they can see clearly, but when they look far into the distance, things look blurry. Myopia is caused because the eyeball is growing too long. And we know that myopia is notorious for changing. It will always tend to get worse over time. Here at Myopia Management, we are committed to prescribing the right way so we can slow down your child's rate of change and produce a healthier eye for them for the future.
I want to ask you about risk factors for myopia. The first one is, what age was your child when they were first diagnosed with myopia? Or what age were they when they got their first pair of glasses? For instance, a child that gets their first pair of glasses at 6 years old or 7 or 8 years old is much more at risk for high levels of myopia that's dangerous than a child that's first diagnosed with myopia at 16 years old. The next is family history. Do you have myopia? Do both parents have myopia? If both parents have myopia, the chance of your child having worsening vision each year and having a high degree of nearsightedness is much higher than if only one or zero parents have it. So that's family history. The third is, how much time does your child spend outside? Are they spending less than 2 hours outdoor a day? Studies have shown that the less time kids spend outside, the higher the risk are for developing myopia in the first place. The last thing I want to ask you is, how much digital device uses does your child have a day? Are they spending more than 2 hours on a screen? If they're spending more time doing near work, reading books, especially during the day, we found that that could be associated with high degrees of myopia. So you're smart to bring your child in for a myopia management consultation at our office. And when they do come in, we're going to run a few tests on them. The first is axial length. We'll be measuring how long the eye is front to back. It's a very important measurement, and we'll be watching that axial length or how long the eye is over the course of time over the next few years. The next is we'll also be measuring the shape of the eye. We do that with a special device called a corneal topographer, which measures the corneal shape of the front of the eye. And lastly, we'll also be measuring your child's prescription if they need glasses or not. That's to determine the baseline glasses prescription to see if it changes and what we need to do today to get them seeing well. Afterwards, we want to review all the test results with you. The first thing we want to do is confirm whether your child has myopia or not. Afterwards, we want to know what level it is today, which will help us predict what the final level of myopia would be untreated once they reach adulthood. Unfortunately, the higher the degree of myopia is, the more likely they are to develop certain conditions of the eye, such as myopic maculopathy, glaucoma, and retinal detachments. Unfortunately, the higher prescriptions, for instance, if they are -8 or higher, they might be more than 100 times more likely to develop myopic maculopathy.
Once we review the results and have our projections of where your child's myopia may be headed, we need to talk about the right kind of treatment to implement today to slow down the rate of progression. This could either be using special types of contact lenses or eye drops, or maybe a combination of the two. This is going to slow down the rate of change and result in a healthier eye for your child for the future. We are so excited to partner with you here at Insight Vision Center Optometry to help manage your child's myopia and to give them a healthier eye for the future. We can't wait to meet you at your next myopia management consultation. We'll see you soon.